Hello ROS developers, welcome to the ROS in 5 minutes video series by The Construct, your channel for anything ROS. I'm by the Adenola. In this video we'll be learning about the ROS parameter server. Of course you can read what the ROS parameter here in this topic, but in this video we'll be taking the practical approach and we'll check some things and see them live. And for this we are using the ROS Development Studio, a powerful online tool for pushing your ROS learning in a practical way. You can create a free account also on this studio and do exactly what you see here and more. We'll find the link to that in the video description. So let's get started. We'll create a new project. And then we launch it. So as I mentioned, we'll be doing practical. So the first thing we want to do is, how do we interact with this server? So it's a parameter server. So let's check the parameters on the server. Rosparam list. That's a command to set the parameters on the server. Oops, what is this? Unable to communicate with master. Yes, this is correct. Because as you will see here, it said the ROS parameter server runs inside of the ROS master. And as you can see here, we are here to start the ROS master. So we are going to do the writing now by starting the ROS master. And we'll do that with the command ROS core. Great. So just from here alone, you can see under what is called parameters here, two parameters are already listed with their value, ROS distro and ROS version with their values in front of them. So let's get back to our command here and see if it works now. Of course it does, because we've started the ROS master and so the parameter server is also working. So the two we saw earlier, ROS distro and ROS version, are here. But these two are new. So, which brings us to the second way to interact with the parameter server, is to actually see the value of the parameters there. So the command is ROS param get. So it means we want to get the value of the parameter. And this returns for us the value. So now the other thing about ROS get that was explained here is the way that it exists in hierarchies here. So which means we can get the whole hierarchy or get part of it. So and we are going to do something similar here. So first let's get ROS, let's use the last command. Let's get up to URIS. So you can see that what we have get is a dictionary with host and then the value, and we can also get up to ROS launch itself. And we can see a bigger dictionary here. So that's it. In this video we just covered the basics of the parameter server. In future videos we might cover more. But before you go, remember to visit the Robot Ignite Academy, our online academy where you'll find practical online ROS courses using simulated robots. No installation required. You just need your computer and your browser, basically. So, did you like the video? If you did, please give us a thumbs up and remember to subscribe to our channel and press the bell for a new video every day. Whether you like it or not, please leave us your thoughts and suggestions in the comments area. Peace out. Odabo.